Hey, it's Martin from SIRS Electronics. Today I wanted to show you guys a different way to power up your LED strips via batteries. Maybe you guys have been wondering how to do it, what kind of battery is good for doing so. And today I'm going to show you the different types of batteries out there that could do this. Basically, there's many types of batteries. There's lead acid, lithium polymer, lithium iron phosphate, NiCad, silicon metal hydride. There's a lot of batteries, but the ones that work best for LED jobs, because they require a lot of current draw, are lithium polymer batteries. Here we have a small 3-cell lithium polymer battery, and by 3-cell, that's how many volts it is. Every cell is about 3.7 volts. This was 11.1 volts. Nominal voltage. There's many different physical sizes. This was a 1200 milliamp battery, and milliamps is how much charge, how much capacity the battery has, which means how long it's going to stay on. So basically, this battery here will stay on maybe for give or take an hour or so, depending how many LED strips you have. So if you have about a whole roll of strip, it'll stay for maybe an hour with 1200 milliamps, but it also depends on how bright you have the strip and all that. So basically, this could be used to substitute a power supply that is powering up your strip, or your controller, or your DMX controller, or whatever it is. So I'm going to show you guys real quick. You could just really simply tap in to the positive or negative wires, and you can actually get your strip to light up. Get it here. So you see there, you can actually get the strip to light up. Of course, if you do a more permanent, more solid hold with the right connectors and the right soldering and all that, you could get it on there solid, and it's not going to budge, you know, and it's going to give you a really reliable setup. There's many different ways to charge a lithium polymer battery. They sell some really basic balanced chargers, such as this one. Basically, you plug one side into your outlet, and then on the other side, you plug in the balancer plug, and you just set it, and then you forget about it, and once the lights turn green, it's been done charging. So, you know, this battery setup is really useful for mobile setups. Like, let's say you have, like, an LED suit, you know, for dancers or whatever, you need it to be wireless. So, you know, you can use a battery to power up. You can make light panels that are wireless, you know, for work or whatever. You can use the same LED. So it could work for many different types. You could even use it with an RF controller. This is for RGB lights, and it has a wireless remote. And this usually takes a power supply on the power input, but you could substitute that with a LiPo like this one. And you plug it in like you would a power supply, and on the other side you plug in your LEDs, and there you go. So about 250 milliamps of charge is going to give you about 5 to 7 minutes of power for a 16.4 foot strip. So depending on that, you know, on the strip and how bright you have it and all that, you could decide which battery power would be the best. So they go anywhere from 250 milliamps all the way to 5,000 or 6,000, even 7,000 milliamps, depending on the battery. Obviously, the more charge it has, the more expensive the battery becomes. But you always want to use 11.1 volt LiPos when you're using them with LEDs. There's a lot of different voltages, but 11.1 is what you want to use. So that's pretty much all there is to it. If you guys have any questions, comments, anything like that, just drop it there in the comment box, and we'll be glad to answer you guys. So thanks for watching.